name's Tori Meister, 28 years old, and I'm from Kailua Kona, Big Island.
Professional surfer Tori Meister has seen some ups and downs in his career, and this past year has been one for the Big Island native to remember. Between massive swells and serious injuries, Tori is ready to put his head down and charge forward.
This has been a crazy year for me. I was kind of coming back from the most major injuries I've ever had in my life. You know, this double up backdoor wave came in, it looked like it was really good, and it was kind of getting windy, and I started paddling. I was like, I don't know, is this a nug? And then it was kind of late, and I was like, oh, this is a sick one. I'm just going to go in, whatever. And I think I hit like a little warble or something, and I just did this like one of the weirdest falls I've ever had, just straight like on my stomach and like real sideways. And I just hit really hard, and I was like, oh, that was a crazy kidney shot, like whatever. And I went up and just got a glass of water, and it felt like I was drinking like fire or something. It was the craziest sensation ever. It was just like instant pain, like real sharp.
With the prognosis of a ruptured spleen, Tori was forced to stay off his feet for several months. Once back in action, a nagging hip turned out to be a torn labrum, requiring surgery and another bout of rehab, keeping him out of the water once more.
You know, it's been about a year and a half now, and it finally feels like I don't have to worry about it every single day. It's not as sore. And so that's something that's really special for me, you know, my body coming back and feeling healthy again. And the whole year was pretty much just injury. And when I came back from that, I was like, all right, I'm good. Like, I'm gonna go surf heavier waves now because I'm good for a while. Like, I've been out for like a whole year. I paid my dues. Like, I'm gonna go surf jobs. Going into the winter season last year, it being El Nino and stuff, it was just the most wild winter I've ever seen. You know, we had so many huge swells, and got aboard and got my stuff together and actually went to go surf, you know, Jaws and stuff. And that was kind of like this crazy eye-opener for me. Like, it was a whole aspect in surfing that I never really done much of. And it kind of like stole my heart. It kind of was everything I wanted to do. You know, every time there was a swell, I was just like, I gotta be there, I can't miss one. It was just kind of been a roller coaster of emotions for me. I mean, when you find something new that you're super excited about, it's kind of something that it's the only thing you want to do, and that was kind of Jaws to me.
Aside from Tori's newfound love for Jaws, competition surfing has always been his bread and butter, finishing this year with a career best result.
Competing's been, you know, the main thing, and I was actually really excited going into Sunset because, you know, I read this WSL post and said if I won Sunset, then I would qualify for the World Tour, and that's, you know, that's been a dream of mine since I started surfing. Going into it, I was like, well, you know, I gotta win this thing, so that's what I'm gonna go out there and do.
Tori put in an incredible showing at this year's Vans World Cup of Surfing. And although he fell short of the win, the result is one he still holds high.
Finish Sunset and make a final is just incredible. It's just, you know, I couldn't believe it. I've actually never made a final in Hawaii, so it was really special for me. It's, you know, been a long time coming, I think, and I've made like a bunch of semifinals and quarters, but never quite got there, you know. So it felt really good to finally get there, and, you know, I felt, you know, I didn't win the contest, but it felt like I was winning.
Spending much of his time while in Hawaii at his second home on the North Shore, Tori has found quite the affinity for the special stretch of reef known as Backdoor, despite the rocky relationship.
Backdoor, oh man, that place has been one of my favorite waves since I was a little kid. I remember surfing it, I think when I was probably 8 years old, and it was only like a 3 foot day out there. And it was like my first or second session, and I hit my face on the reef, and I like split my under my lip real bad, and it was kind of just, you know, gushing out blood. And I was just from duck diving away, the wave just slammed my face straight into the reef. Fear has been something that she's given me right away. I still love the wave more than, you know, any wave in the world. It's the most perfect, fearful, crazy. I've never been so pushed down into the reef in my life from any other wave, where it just really just feels like it's trying to push you through the reef. When you get hurt, one thing you always learn is how much you appreciate surfing and how amazing the gift is that we have. You're out for 2 weeks and you just start itching, oh man, I wanna surf. And then when you're out for 3 months, all you wanna do is go surfing. I was pretty nervous when I was coming back. I remember my first session at Backdoor, I was, you know, feeling really scared, and, you know, that wave, it wasn't the heaviest wipeout of my life, that's for sure. It definitely wasn't the biggest wave I've ever fell on, but it almost kill me, you know? So it made me have a crazy respect for the ocean, obviously, like I always have had, and pipeline. For me, I was like, well, you know, you either gotta surf this wave 100% or just don't surf it. And that was kind of like my whole game plan last year was like, just go for it as much as you can because I want to live every day to the fullest, you know? And I want to go surf a crazy big wave and I want to do these things that I haven't really done because for me, I wouldn't be as satisfied if I wouldn't push harder. I would be really disappointed in myself. So the first session at Backdoor, I was really disappointed in myself for not pushing myself. And I was like, never again, like, I want you, you know, you got to go all out or nothing. No more second guessing.